In an effort to ensure that recovery houses in the Commonwealth provide a safe environment for residents in the surrounding communities, I have introduced House Bill 1884. It creates the Certified Recovery Residence Act. The Act establishes the State Board of Recovery Residences within the Bureau of Professional and Occupational Affairs. The Board is charged with administration of the certification program for residences and administrators. This program includes ongoing evaluation and oversight, as well as the development of a code of ethics for administrators and staff. Some of the major provisions are inspections of recovery residences upon application for certification, as well as on-site monitoring, background screenings for owners, directors, financial officers, and administrators. The Department of State will maintain a list of certified recovery residences, which will be available on their public website. Service providers will only be able to refer patients to certified recovery residences. Providers or agencies that refer individuals to non-certified homes will be ineligible for state funding and will face fines. Large parts of this bill were modeled after legislation creating voluntary certification for recovery residences in Florida, which was passed favorably by their General Assembly in 2015. As of March 2016, over 600 residences were certified, and their number is expected to climb to 1,000 by the end of the year. I look forward to hearing the testimony of all the individuals today. Part of this today, for me, this has been an ongoing process for the last 3 years, but it is a complicated issue, and a lot of the people here, and I'm talking about my colleagues, might not necessarily have hit the amount of recovery houses that are in my district. Right now, we're dealing with over 95 of them that are specifically in one municipality, and there's a lot more that are running under the radar. So I want to, that is why this all began. So I just wanted to end up with, there are hundreds more across the Commonwealth that fly under the radar, making it unsafe, unhealthy, and non-conducive to sobriety. These are called rogue homes. Since the Federal Fair Housing Act was amended by Congress in 1988 to add protections for persons with disabilities, some landlords use the law as a shield from local government control, calling their boarding homes recovery homes. It is imperative that we work collaboratively to create a balance within our communities in order to provide these individuals residing in sober living homes with the best opportunity to achieve recovery. I also want to thank, the state already has a task force that has been ongoing, and I know they're starting to wrap it up, which I'm thrilled, but we couldn't wait in Bristol Township anymore, so that's why I had to have this hearing. And I also want to help my colleague, Caitlin, Brian Allen, we have a representative from Mike Fitzpatrick's office here who was very helpful in a lot of this homework. So thank you.